Landscape irrigation is really the biggest source of water use at a residential property. So it's really critical that a couple of times of the year that you kind of go through the property, go through the irrigation system, and make sure you don't have any leaks, make sure everything is working like it should be. So I'm gonna take you through a couple of steps and processes that are really easy things for helping you to figure out what's going on with the irrigation system. So drip irrigation is how we water most of our landscapes in our community. The hard thing about drip irrigation is most of it is underground. You don't see it, which is a good thing because it's protecting it from the sun. But if you have things like leaks or heads that aren't working like they should be, sometimes it's a little hard to see. And so if you see something like this with our drip irrigation heads, it's very small, the flow is coming out like it should be, but again, it's really hard to kind of see it. So you kind of got to take a little bit of extra kind of effort to walk around your yard to make sure everything is working correctly. Sometimes the leaks are very obvious. If you see something like this and it's shooting out and this is not what it should be doing. Obviously it should be very small with a head that's close onto the landscape. If you're in a front yard, this could actually be waterways for you because this could be going into the street. So these are the first things that you want to check for. The other thing is I always say listen. So when you're walking around your yard and the system is running, you shouldn't hear flowing of water, you shouldn't hear it spraying. So that's a two-step process, really. One is visually looking for things, but the other part is also listening for it. So when you want to fix leaks in the drip system, there's kind of two different things you can use. The first one is just replacing the actual head itself. The second is what we call a goof plug. So sometimes you'll find that you have a leak and it's not where there are any plants. You just have a hole. Goof plugs are a great tool to use to plug those holes. These are if you have water that's basically leaking by a plant, but you want to have it controlled, not have it spraying everywhere. Each of these, if you go to a nursery or hardware store, a couple dollars to buy a pack of them. So a very cheap fix that again will save you a lot of money from basically a lot of wasted water. So using one of the two tools, like I said, another drip head or a goof plug, you basically have this quarter inch pipe. In the industry, we call this spaghetti pipe, but it's the very small pipe. And you can tell it's a very small opening like that. And so you're basically just putting one of these heads. It takes a little wiggling, a little pressure, but it's really an easy fix. So when you're replacing the drip heads, just pay attention to the flow also. So that you'll notice the openings are very small on them. And there's a lot of different flows. They go half gallon, gallon, two, and then they can start going up quite a bit. So just make sure you pay attention to that because that really impacts how you're gonna water your landscape. We always encourage the smaller flows so that, the 1 to 2 gallons. The other thing that can sometimes happen is when you're walking the landscape, you'll notice that maybe you have the heads there, but water's not coming out. Sometimes that's because the openings are so small that there can be debris or air pockets in it. And so sometimes you may just replace that head with a new head and it'll work totally fine. But again, sometimes what we have is we see people where they will actually increase watering because they think the plant's not doing well, and it's actually maybe just an issue with the little head itself. So a lot of what I just talked about was checking your drip irrigation system, but there are people that still have grass. Grass is a totally different type of watering system. A lot more water is being used, and it's a lot more obvious to see if you have irrigation leaks. But again, with all the different types of irrigation, all the different types of landscape you have, want to walk around your property a couple of times a year just to make sure you don't have leaks. That's a way for you to kind of keep your water use down, keep your water bills lower, and basically have a healthy landscape.